Hello everyone. Today we are going to discuss about like how we are going to create a models on top of your application. So before we step into the actual discussion, like in general, we will be writing the test cases manually. For either it might be a test documentation or it might be an automation. Like we will be writing the scripts, right? When you are writing a test, manual test cases, you will be missing, like if multiple resources are working on the same application and multiple resources are trying to write the test cases for different modules, there might be a chances of inconsistency in wording. So to avoid those kind of situations and to avoid writing the scripts for multiple test cases, like what if we have 100 or 1,000 test cases of same application? So will that be possible to complete within a days, all those things? So to avoid those kind of consequences, so we are going to create a model using the Conformic, and on a single click, you are going to generate those many test cases. Either it might be for a manual test cases or automation scripts, or those generated test cases can be uploaded for the test management tools like ALM and all. So today we are going to discuss like how we are going to generate the automation scripts and we are going to execute those scripts from using the Eclipse. So, right. So before generating the test cases, we have to consider an application and create an activity diagram and structure diagram for the flow that you are considering. And after the completion of your creating a structure diagram and activity diagram, we have to generate the test cases for whichever the format that we are looking for. So let me go with creating a new project, and I'm just creating a new project here and giving the project name as demo using a template here. See, we have a three different options saying using template and empty projects and import model files. So like when you are using a template, you will be having a model folder in your project. So that means you are going to have an activity diagram and structure diagram, an empty activity diagram and structure diagram. So that you no need to create a new activity diagram when you are coming newly. So this is my new project that I have created so far. So where exactly we are going to work with creating models? So we are going to work with model folder mainly. This is a structure diagram. On top of it, you are also going to get .sl file. So this .sl file is nothing but it is a reference to your structure diagram to generate the test cases from backend. So we are not going to do anything with .sl file. We just have to update whatever the screens that we are seeing on the application. All those widgets are going to updated or modified from your structure diagram. So when I open this structure diagram, how exactly I'm going to create a mockup screens that are related to your application in structure diagram? So that is how we are going to see now. So when coming to application, like you may ask me a question saying like, you're not going to give any reference from your application to this Conformic. So then how we are going to create all those screens, widgets, and objects, like data entry objects from application to Conformic. So here, this is an empty canvas where you are going to create models, like mockup screens on top of your application. So if I see here, these are the widgets that the structure diagram is going to allow me. So before going to create the structure diagram, let me show you like what is the scenario that we are going to consider to generate the test cases. So let me go for Notepad. So what is the thing that we are going to consider now? So I'm just considering a parabank, a sample application to show you how we are going to create activity diagrams and structure diagram and generating the test cases on top of it. So yeah, I just want to display login screen and in that I want to enter username and password. So these are my fields, and then I want to click on login button. Right? So this is the flow that I am considering so far. So for this, I have to create a structure diagram. So what is the thing that I am considering now is screen, right? A login screen. I just have to give a screen here saying login. So inside it, I just have to create a form. Why? Because I am considering a data entry object saying text boxes, like username and password are my text boxes. To represent those two, I just have to create form. So in my form, I'm going to create username and password text boxes. Username is my one of text box and password. So right on top of my screen, I'm going to click on this login button. So this is how I am going to create my structure diagram. Once you are done with creating the structure diagram, go for creating the activity diagram. So before you go for creating the activity diagram, so whatever the widgets that you have created in your structure diagram, so you are going to do an action based on these mock-up screens that you have created in structure diagram. So if you see here, what and all the actions that are, what and all the screens and widgets that you have created in your structure diagram, on top of that, all those actions will be reflected in your actions tab. So, right, you have to use these existing actions and create the activity diagram. So let me go to activity diagram. So the major difference between structure diagram and activity diagram is, like, in structure diagram, you are going to specify like what you are going to test on your application. But coming to activity diagram, you are going to mention how you are going to test. So the flow, like what is the next step for the initial step? So these kind of actions you are going to specify in activity diagram. So structure diagram is nothing but what you are going to test, and activity diagram is how we are going to test. So when I'm creating an activity diagram, my flow starts from initial node. So, right, and then I'll be going with creating an activity node. So in what is my flow I am considering here is, like, I just have to display first login screen and then enter username and password and then click on the login button. So if I see, this is my verification action. So I'm just drag and dropping this login screen. I just want to display login screen. So if I mouse over on this action, I can see a text it is displaying saying that display login screen, right? So similarly, what I want to do is, like, I want to enter fill customer login form. So I want to fill username and password over here. And then I just want to click on login button. Right. So this is how my creation of activity diagram is also done. So far we are done with creating structure diagram and activity diagram for one of the flow, right? So the next step for me is, like, I just have to generate the test cases. If I go to Conformic Test Design tab, I did not click load model yet. So I cannot see what and all the activity nodes and actions that are there in my activity diagram loaded yet. So once I click on this, all my things will get loaded here. So, right, so far I have a 6 actions, like testing goals in my activity diagram. If I expand this, I'll be having all this. So, like, these are my nodes and control flows and action invocations. So once I click on the generate test cases, if any of this has been missed, then I'll not get 100% coverage here. If I'm not getting 100% coverage, then that means, like, you are doing something mistake in your activity diagram. So you have to make sure to have 100%. So once I click on generate test cases, based on the flow that I have provided in my activity diagram, those many test cases, optimized test cases will be generated. So far, I just have only one activity node in my flow. So I just got only one test case. So if I go here, if I click on, this is the conformic test review tab. This is nothing but once the test cases are generated, you can review those test cases, whether they are appropriate or not. So I click on this node initial in the sense it is considering this node initial as a test case name. So because we have not yet provided any test case name to the tool or model that we have created. So this is nothing but a model browser where you can see if you have a multiple subactivity diagrams in it as well. You can overview from here, like where it is navigating, like from which flow to which flow. So these kind of reviews you can do from model browser. So similarly, you have here a test case that is selected. So you can see what and all the actions that are there in your that current test case. So this is my display screen. So the first action. Similarly, I have a fill form. If you see here, I have a two text boxes, username and password, and I did not provided any test data into it. So by default, it is considering it as a don't care, right? And then we are clicking on a button. So click button, that button name is login. So this is how you can do the test review, like test case review from conformic test review tab. So once you're confirmed with your all test cases and you're okay with the test cases that are generated so far. So now what you have to do is like you have to export test cases. When I see here, my export test cases got disabled. So because if I come to my project, this is interlinked with your DC. So DC is nothing but design configuration here. So far the test cases generated are common for every scripter. So if I right click on this DC and select scripting backend, so these are all the plugins that I have to which format I want to export my existing test cases, right? If I use Excel scripter, I'll be getting a test documentation using the Excel. Like my test cases will be uploaded into Excel scripter. And today I want to go with Selenium JavaScripter. So I am just selecting this Selenium JavaScripter and let's see like how the test cases are going to generate. So right, if I click on this export test cases, my test cases will get exported to this particular formats. So far I don't have any other formats other than this model, right? Let's see like how many folders and files are going to generate now. So the test rendering is also done, right? If I go here, I have, so these two Excel template and Excel test suite are nothing but you're generating two test documentation. And if I go to Selenium Java, in this, I have four different files generated. So one is source and test HTML files and GUI action automation mapping and natural language automation. So these files are for internal reference of conforming. So the main Java files will be resided in your source folder. So coming to this page objects are nothing but whatever the widgets that you have created in your structure diagram. So for each screen, you are going to get one Java file. And where exactly your test cases are going to reside is like test suite. So for each test case, you are going to have a node initial.java. That means like each Java file. So for each test case, you are going to have a .java file. So you might ask me a question like where exactly you are going to upload or give your object locators and locator types. So, right? So you will be having one more object repository scripter. Let me add that scripter as well and to show you. Yeah. So I'll just remove this Excel scripter as we are not using for now. So I'm just exporting again. I just have to export so that I'll get object repository Excel file generated. So if you see in my project, I have object repository Excel folder. So in that I'll be having object repository.xls. So if I open that, okay, let me close this and show you. So what and all the widgets that I have created in my structure diagram, all those widgets will be uploaded into Excel, like object repository Excel, so that from here you can provide what is the locator type and what is the object locator. If that is an XPath, then you can just provide here as an XPath and you can copy paste all those locator values from your application to here. So from here, again, update this. And again, you have to do an import saying that my object locators are updating from here. So right, for time being, I just have already created the model and generated the test cases. If I open this, let me close this object repository Excel. Yep. So this is how, like I just have updated this particular Excel file with all my object locators. So, right. So this is how we have to do it. And once this is done, and you have, as I said, we have to import, and then we have to disable this object repository and then have to generate the test cases. So based on that, whatever you have done the import, you will be getting all the locator values will be updated from here. So yeah, sorry, I just have opened the different. If I open this .sl, whatever the things like whatever the XPaths, locator types and locator values that I have updated from this object repository.xlsx, all those will get imported into your .sl file. That means you can export those test cases to Selenium or any other automation scripters that you want to export. So, right? So once I'm done, like let me open and show you like how many scenarios I am considering. So this is a model that I have created, and on top of this customer login, I just have provided a decision, and then I'll be having one error screen and two different flows like open new account and transfer funds. So on top of it, I'm going to generate So I have a five different test cases. So three for error and two for valid flows. So based on the decision, these many test cases are going to generate. So what I have to do is like, I just have to open my Eclipse and the Conformic team will be providing you a sample folder. You just have to copy paste the existing source SRC folder into your Eclipse project. So let's see like how we are going to execute that as well. So I'm just opening this Eclipse IDE. So I have already used this. So this is my sample project and I just have copy pasted for time being. If I open like what exactly this page objects are and how exactly this test suite and all are going to generate. So if I open this up, open new account or welcome screen, let me open this welcome screen and explain you. So this is my welcome page, right? In that I have a username, password, text boxes. So if you see here, my methods that are related to my username text box will be started from find by annotation. So for every widget that you have created in structure diagram, for each widget, you are going to have a three different methods. So one is like verify that particular text box or any other widget, verify widget, and verify status, widget status. So either it is enabled, visible, hidden, or disabled, and the action that you want to do on that widget. So I just want to enter some data into that username text box. So set username text box. So here you are going to have a send keys method. So this is how, similarly, like if I am using any click button, so the same. So this is related to my login button, right? I have the same, like verify status, and then I'm going to click on this button. So this is how the methods are going to generate from Conformic. So this is how you can just export the test cases based on the model that you have created. So if I go to the test cases, like this is my open new account test case that is generated when I clicked on the generate test cases. So if I see here, so my test case step starts from here. Like I am going to enter URL, first step as enter URL, and then verify login screen. And the third step is like I just have to click on customer login screen, and I'm going to click on a button. So these are the methods. On top of it, you're going to call the actual methods from page objects. So, right? So these are the test cases that are residing in test suite, and these are the page objects that are going to generate on top of the structure diagram screens that you have created. So the utilities. So these are the configurations. If you want to change a browser type here, you can provide, you can change like a to Firefox or any other browser that you want to use. And you have a page object base. So this is nothing but from here, you are going to call the driver methods. You are initializing the driver from page object base class, right? So here you have a testdata.xls. This is nothing but whatever the data that you want, you are providing from models like activity diagram. So for each test case, you are going to have each sheet in your testdata.xls file. So these test data files are also generating by default here. So when you export test cases, all these files are going to generate by default. You're not going to do anything. Like you're not going to do manual modifications. Like if you want to add, you can just add those test data into this Excel file. You no need to add this kind of testdata.xls files. By default, the tool will create and gives you the entire things that you want to work on this current project. So our next step is like, we just have to export. We just no need to do anything, as the Conformic team is going to provide you all this support files using this sample project. You can just rename it and copy the scripts that are generated from Conformic into this sample project. So you just have to run it now. Like right click on this test case and just click on run as test engine. So whatever the URL that I have provided here, that is going to enter here. So maybe the credentials are got time up. So the execution has got failed, but this is how you can do. Like you can just open the browser and you can automate the scripts using the conformic models. So this is where we are end up with the execution as well. And if I go to my conformic again, so far we have just seen like how the execution takes place, right? If I go to my conformic tab, conformic modeling tab, and say I have the requirements that I have to add into my model, I can just go for actions and I can just use this actions into my conformic and say the ad hoc requirements. Like you can just provide the ad hoc requirements, or if you have any requirement documents that are coming from ALM or that are coming from Jira or any Excel providers, then you can just go and add from requirement providers, and then you can map those external requirement providers to conformic models so that you can see the traceability matrix that is going to generate from conformic. So this is all about like how we are going to use the conformic to generate the test cases and to execute automatically without any manual intervention, until and unless you are just going to create models on top of your application. So hope this helps you. Thank you.